Good morning, and welcome to our 9 o'clock contemporary service. I'm Pastor Nanette Christofferson, and along with Pastor Steve Talmadge, we're so glad that you're with us today. Happy St. Patrick's Day. I hope you all have an opportunity, as you will hear in Pastor Steve's sermon, to learn a little bit more about St. Patrick. There's lots of good news that he spread of our Lord Jesus Christ to all of Ireland, and it's so much more than green beer and all of the other celebrations that go on. Hospitality today is out on the patio, and if you'd like to enjoy a cup of coffee, get to know others, and there's always some delicious treats, we ask and invite you to spend some time and enjoy their hospitality. Our last Wednesday soup supper is this Wednesday. It's the last Wednesday of Lent. Actually, next week is Holy Week. So this week, on Wednesday, we are having soup supper at 5:30. Our service starts at 6:15, our meditation service, and then at 7 o'clock, we'll hear from our faith and action team of the things that we're doing as a church, and we ask that you come with questions, because through your questions, we often learn more of what we can do. We've had opportunities to learn about ELCA ministries during this Lenten season, and some local ministries as well, and so we continue to invite you to these fellowship times after the meditation service. There is no Sunday school today. It's spring break, but please make sure your kids come next Sunday as we have a very special activity in Godly Play for them. Holy Week services are announced in our e-news, so please take note of that and put it on your calendar. We are saying goodbye to a saint here at Love of Christ. Ken Andreko passed away. There will be a memorial service for him next Saturday at 10 o'clock. And just a couple other things to mention that are going on around here. Some of you have heard of our ministry, Sleep in Heavenly Peace, that we work with. Jan has blankets that she makes, and she'd like to teach others on how to make them. And I'd like you just to stand up real quick so you can put a name and a face together. And if you're interested in making blankets, there will be a time of getting together, a short class, where you can learn how to make these blankets for Sleep in Heavenly Peace as well. So please talk to Jan if you have any questions. And also, all this information is in our e-news as well. I'm not going to forget today. We're going to start with confession, and so I'd like you to turn all heads to the screen, please, as we begin our worship. I'll read it really. Jesus says, "The time is red. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe the gospel. O come, let us return unto our God, who will have mercy and abundantly pardon. Let us pray. Most holy God, we admit to you and each other, we are so dazzled by false gods of this age, we find it hard to recognize who we are, where we came from, or where we are going. We easily become caught up in selfishness, seduced by cynicism, waylaid by glittering consumerism, and led by the nose along the highways and byways created by powerful invested interests. Please open our eyes that we may see ourselves more clearly and seek you more diligently. Amen." Fellow travelers on the road to Easter, always remember that there is much more forgiveness in God that we could ever exhaust. Receive from God, through the grace of Christ, the blessing of sins forgiven and a right relationship restored. Amen.
Good morning. If we would please rise, I invite you to lift your hearts and lift your voices. Thank you for coming to worship with us this morning. Our first song, we are going to celebrate the fact that there is honey in the rock, which means God has seen this day ahead and made provision for you.
There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need you got. There's honey in the rock, You only you can satisfy. Sweetness at the mercy seat. Now I've tasted, it's not hard to see. Only you can satisfy. There's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock. Honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock. Freedom where the spirit is. Bounty in the wilderness. You will always satisfy. There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need you got. There's honey in the rock, purpose in your plan, power in the blood, healing in your hands, blood and flowing when you said it was done. Everything you did's enough. I keep looking, I keep finding. You keep giving, keep providing. I have all I need. You are all I need. I keep praying, you keep moving. I keep praising, you keep moving. I have all I need. You are all I need. There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need you got. There's honey in the rock, purpose in your plan, power's in the blood, healing in your hands. Started flowing when you said it was done. Jesus, who you are is enough. There's honey in the rock.
Let's praise him this morning. Now we will do the Lord's Prayer.
Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done. On earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done. On earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us. Forgive us as we forgive the ones who sinned against us. Forgive them and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Let your kingdom come. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven. Let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done on earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us as we forgive the ones who sinned against us. Forgive them and lead us not to temptation, but to live. Your kingdom come. It's yours. All yours. The kingdom, the power, the glory, all yours. It's yours. All yours. Forever and ever. The kingdom is yours. It's yours. All yours, the king. let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done. On earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. On earth as in heaven, right here in my heart.
And let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you this day, Lord, with grateful hearts, with hearts filled with thanksgiving for the amazing God that you are. Lord God, as we enter into praise and worship of you, might we forget those lists of things to do. Focus our hearts, focus our minds on word, on song, on scripture. Guide everything that we do in this service as a means and way to draw closer to you as your grace reigns all over us. God, bring to us hearts that truly want your will to be done. And God, as we enter into this time of thanksgiving and praise and worship, may it be an offering to you. We ask this in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated. Would the children please come forward for the children's message?
Got some stuffies here. We got teddy bear. We got, is that a bunny rabbit too? We got two bunny rabbits? That's what happens when you got bunnies. You always got more than one, right? All right. Well, I brought a picture today. And what is in the guy's hands? What?
Seeds.
Do you see them? And what do you do with seeds?
You plant them.
You do? You don't throw them up in the air?
No.
You don't wash them down the drain?
No.
No. You plant them. Yeah. Where do you plant them?
In the dirt.
In the dirt. Yeah, you usually need dirt, right? Soil, some sort of, and you need some water, and you need some air, all that stuff. And then hopefully, when you plant them, what do you hope happens?
They grow.
They grow. And what kind of seeds, looking at the picture, what kind of,
tomatoes.
Yeah, we don't know exactly what seeds, but they're vegetables probably, or fruit.
We have spray by the Target.
Yeah?
We have to spray because we don't have water, but we do have water from this, but we have water.
Yeah, water's a good thing, isn't it? You got to have water to grow the plants, right?
Yes.
Yeah. That's right. They won't grow without the water. Well, Jesus uses a story about seeds. He tells lots of stories about seeds. But today in our Bible reading, he's going to tell about a seed of grain needing to be buried in the ground so it can grow more grain. And he uses that story to teach about what's going to happen to him and what's going to happen to him on the day we call Good Friday. Anybody know? What happens to Jesus on Good Friday? He dies on a cross. But he doesn't stay there. Where does he go? He gets buried in a tomb. And then on Easter morning, what happens? He rose from the dead. And did that change the world? Did that change lots of people's lives? And you know that some people believe there are 2 billion people on this planet who know Jesus and believe in Jesus because he died and rose. That's pretty good seed, isn't it, if you get 2 billion out of one, isn't it? But you need water, you need air, you need soil, you know, all that stuff. But I think you need a lot of love, too. So let's, well, you got to wait. We got to pray first. All right, let's pray. Fold our hands, bow our heads. Dear God, thank you for using stories to teach us how you share your love like a seed being buried that then grows and touches so many lives. Help us to remember what you've done for the world through dying and rising, through the life of Jesus. In his name we pray. Amen. All right. Thanks, kids. Let's stand for the gospel.
Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Now among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew, and then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there my servant will be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No. It is for this reason that I have come to this hour." The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said, "An angel has spoken to him." Jesus answered, "This voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from earth, will draw all people to myself." He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. The gospel of our Lord. Praise to you.
You may be seated. It seems a couple of times a year the Lord of creation likes to give me a Barry White voice. So I'm battling some allergies here, so I pray that I will get through this without hacking. I made it through the first service, but some of you can empathize with me. Grace and peace to you from Jesus Christ, the Son of humanity and the Son of God. Amen. Maybe they had heard rumors. Maybe one of them or some of them had listened to a few of his stories. Maybe they had encountered some of his followers while working, trading, or traveling through his home territory. Maybe they watched with amazement as he courageously did some house cleaning and priority adjusting in his father's house in the very spot where strangers and foreigners were often invited and welcomed. Maybe they witnessed his humble entrance into the city while riding a donkey with a crowd singing songs of praise and future hope. We don't know for sure, but this morning we find some whose ethnic identity or whose first language places them in the category of Greeks. Greeks. They're on a quest. They're on a quest to find Jesus. They're among the throng of religious pilgrims, vendors, dignitaries, soldiers, and regular residents who caused the city of Jerusalem to swell maybe 3 to 5 times its normal size as the festival of Passover is near. Like religious pilgrims or leaders who travel to Rome and go to the Vatican with hopes to seek an audience with the Pope, these Greeks, they seek an audience with Jesus, with this uncredentialed, unconventional free agent rabbi or teacher, Jesus. They approach Philip, whom you might remember from an earlier gospel reading, wanted to introduce his buddy Nathanael to Jesus up in Galilee. But Nathanael wasn't all excited about meeting this one from Nazareth because it was out there and it was pretty well known that nothing good ever comes from Nazareth. But after spending a little time with Jesus, Nathanael comes around. He comes around and he becomes a part of the disciples of Jesus. Now, Greeks who may have recognized Philip as part of Jesus' inner circle or heard a little Galilean accent or maybe heard a few words of Greek rather than Aramaic come out of the mouth of Philip bring their request to him to see Jesus. We don't know why Philip went to Andrew first before going to Jesus. Given the religious and political tension in the air and the attitude of some of the most religious around them, emphasizing keep your distance from non-Jews, Philip may have wanted to incorporate the buddy system in case things get a little controversial or disruptive. When Jesus hears about the Greeks' request, he announces not the beginning of March Madness, who will name the next basketball champions in college world, but he announces Good Friday and Easter are closer than you can imagine. This little sign of non-Jews wanting to see Jesus in the center of Judaism, Jerusalem, the temple, rooted in God's ancient covenants way back in Genesis forward, that those covenants were to be lived out in such a way that all nations on this earth might be blessed, moves Jesus to declare, now. Now is the time, the hour. What Jesus started by his taking on flesh and dwelling among us, as John says in chapter 1, by his being declared the light of the world, which the darkness of sin can never extinguish, by John's declaration of Jesus being the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, by Jesus' own admission of being the good shepherd who cares for his flock, the vine which sustains abundant life, the bread of life which satisfies the growing hunger of our quest for meaning, purpose, and value. And Jesus saying himself to be the resurrection and the life, who overcomes death so that all may live in the presence of God's unconditional life and love. All of this leading up to these Greeks seeking Jesus, along with Jesus declaring that he's the way, the truth, and the life. All of this is happening there in Jerusalem, where Jesus is going to fully reveal who he is by being lifted up. Whether he is speaking to just Philip and Andrew or to seeking Greeks, Jesus offers a teaching moment. Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it multiplies and bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me. And where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Jesus is trying to make it clear. He's trying to make it clear dying to self and living for God is the way to real life and abundant life. Only by spending our lives, the gift of the life that you and I have been given from the day of our birth until the day of our death, that life we have been given is to be given away. Because in giving it away, we experience the life that God meant us to have. Only by service comes real greatness. On this day linked to the death of St. Patrick, most of us may have no clue how God used this guy over 1,600 years ago. We don't know a lot about Patrick, but you need to erase the idea of Patrick chasing all the snakes out of Ireland. Or there were no Christians on the island of Ireland before Patrick. What we do know is Patrick was kidnapped. Kidnapped as a teenager by invading Irish raiders who attacked his family estate in northern Britain. Patrick had been raised by his parents to be a Christian. During this time, he worked as a shepherd, outdoors and away from people, lonely and afraid. He turned to his religion for comfort and solace. He grew in his understanding of who God is in Jesus. After more than 6 years as a slave, as a prisoner, Patrick escaped. According to his writing, a voice, which he believed to be God, spoke to him in a dream, telling him it was time to leave Ireland. To do so, Patrick walked from County Mayo, where he is believed he was held, to the Irish coast, and he got on a boat, smuggled his way out. And after escaping to Britain, Patrick reported experiencing a second revelation. An angel in a dream tells him he needs to go back. He needs to return to Ireland as a missionary. Soon after, Patrick began religious training, a course of study that lasted more than 15 years. And after his ordination as a priest, he was sent back to Ireland with a dual mission: to minister to Christians already living there, many of them enslaved, and to begin to convert the pagans. Familiar with the Irish language and culture, Patrick chose to incorporate traditional rituals. Excuse me. So he chose to incorporate traditional rituals into the lessons of Christianity instead of attempting to eradicate native Irish beliefs. For instance, he used bonfires to celebrate Easter, since the Irish were used to honoring their gods with fire. He also superimposed the sun on the cross, because the sun was a powerful Irish symbol, and so he put it on around a cross to create what is now called the Celtic cross, so that the veneration of the symbol would seem more natural to the Irish. We need to remember that Patrick could have chosen the easy path. Patrick could have stayed safe behind the walls of Christendom. But listening to the Holy Spirit and feeling the call and burden of those who did not know Christ, or those who found themselves a part of a minority movement of faith in a majority pagan territory, he chose to die to self and to live for God. Because of this servant of Christ, many of us wear a little green today, probably clueless of the story of the man whose day we honor. In our lesson for this day, Jesus is certain that through his death, through the cross, the power of evil that continues to dominate our world can be broken. It is in the cross that the power of God to draw all people is found, because it is in the cross that you and I can see God's commitment to be in relationship with all people out of a motivation of love rather than anger or wrath. And many of us who are here know this to be true. We know that Jesus doesn't fix our problems. Many of us know the involuntary experiences of losing a spouse through death or unexpected divorce. Many of us know what it's like to lose a child to an incurable disease, a tragic accident, addictive substances, or just stupid choices. Many of us know the downside of a down economy or downsizing workplaces. Many of us know bodies that are no longer able to do what they used to do because of age, disease, genetics, or poor management. Many of us know the struggle to make ends meet because of the lost job or lack of discipline in living within our means. Or we watched our investments continue to shrink in value due to a variety of other factors. Yet we still come. We come and we gather in a place like this, knowing that Jesus doesn't necessarily take our problems away or fix our problems, but like the Greeks who want to see Jesus, what is the draw? Could it be a sense of hope and confidence not rooted in your ability or mine, but God's ability to get us through whatever we are going through? Could it be that we have discovered that through the events and circumstances that crash into our lives unexpectedly, that we begin to realize we're mortal? We have limits, and we're not invincible. But in this place and in our hearts, we have come to know a God who identifies with our struggle, even to the point of dying. Could it be that because of Christ's death and his resurrection from the grave, we have found the ability to persevere and to continue to take risks in loving service toward others because we know and believe God is able? God is able to bring victory, triumph, and new life out of what appears to be utter rejection and defeat. Jesus said, "And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself." Unlike other religions in the world, unlike other spiritual examples or leaders, the draw of the Christian faith and the draw of Jesus is we proclaim through the cross we believe in a God who does not promise us the world or choose to escape the world. No, we believe in a God who voluntarily, willingly, and out of love for each of us is willing to suffer for this world and die for each of us. We believe in a God who invites us to accept his lordship and follow his leadership over our lives because of what he's willing to go through and endure because of his one great desire. Have a relationship. To have a relationship that lasts forever with you, with me, and with all people. Maybe this is why those Greeks wanted an audience with Jesus. Amen.
With the whole church, let us confess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As we continue our worship, it's my prayer that we really see this place where we worship as a house of miracles.
This is a house of worship. This is a place of praise, where every demon trembles, where we proclaim your name. Come alive in the name of Jesus. This is a house of miracles. We bring everything to the feet of Jesus. Everything in the name of Jesus. This is a house of miracles. Resurrection power. Your blood runs through our veins. Your kingdom triumphs over even the coldest grave. We sing, come alive in the name of Jesus. Come alive in the name of Jesus. This is a house of miracles. We bring everything to the feet of Jesus. Everything in the name of Jesus. This is a house of miracles. We sing, come alive in the name of Jesus. Come alive in the name of Jesus. This is a house of miracles. We bring everything to the feet of Jesus. Everything in the name of Jesus. This is a house of miracles. I still believe you're moving. I still believe you're speaking. God, all things for good. Jesus. This is the house of miracles. We bring everything to the name of Jesus. Everything in the name of Jesus. This is a house of miracles.
With the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation. Hear us, O God. God of the world, may we as followers of Christ guide all who wish to see Jesus. Guide us to be that light of life and love so the world can see Jesus. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. God of peace and reconciliation, we pray for peace among nations who are in conflict and war, especially Palestine and Israel, Syria, Myanmar, Russia, and Ukraine and Sudan. We pray for stability amidst political transition in Haiti. Hear us, O God. God of all that exists, you lavish the earth with extravagant beauty. Preserve the rich and complex diversity of living things. Guide us to persevere this amazing, to preserve this amazing creation you have given us. Hear us, O God. God of compassion, we lift up those grieving friends and family members following a school bus crash in Rushville, Illinois. Hear us, O God. God of the covenant, through the church you draw us into community. We give thanks for the means of grace around which we gather. Inspire, Lord. Inspire musicians. Hear us, O God. God of goodwill, you restore what is broken. We pray for any experiencing estrangement, conflict, or abuse in families and intimate relationships. Protect and comfort all who are vulnerable, especially those living in institutions. Hear us, O God. God of every time and place, you are with us. Move us to reach out to any who are homebound, lonely, grieving, in treatment, or ill. Today we lift up Jason, Connie, Barb, Ann, Larry, Peter, Kim, Rod, Kate, Sarah, Hadley. Lord, we pause now to lift up those who are on our hearts. For all whom we have named, Lord, we ask for your healing presence to surround all whom we love. Hear us, O God. God of promise, we give you thanks for the saints whose faith inspires us, especially Patrick, missionary to Ireland. Grant us faith to trust in your everlasting love. Hear us, O God. Into your hands, gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Give me eyes to see more of who you are.
May what I behold still my anxious heart. Take what I have known and break it all apart. You, my God, are greater still, and no sky contains, no doubt restrains all you are. The greatness of our God, I spend my life to know, and I'm far from close to all you are. The greatness of our God. Give me grace to see beyond this moment here, that there's nothing left to fear, and that you alone are high above it all. You, my God, are greater still, and no sky contains, no doubt restrains all you are. The greatness of our God, I spend my life to know, far from close to all you are. The greatness of our God, and no sky contains, no doubt restrains all you are. The greatness of our God, I spend my life to know, and I'm far from close to all you are. The greatness of our God. And there is nothing that could ever separate us. There is nothing that could ever separate us from your love. I spend my life to know, and I'm far from close to all you are. The greatness of our God, and no sky contains, no doubt restrains all you are. The greatness of our God, I spend my life to know, far from close to all you are. The greatness of our God, all you are. The greatness of our God.
On the night in which our Lord Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, and he gave thanks, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup, and he gave thanks, And he gave it to his disciples, saying, "This cup is the new covenant of my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come to the banquet, for all is ready now.
The hands that serve the wine and the bread, and the sons of the earth, how beautiful the feet that walked the long dusty roads and the hill to the cross, how beautiful. Is the body of Christ. How beautiful the heart that bled, that took all my sin and bore it instead. How beautiful the tender that chose to forgive and never despise. How beautiful. How beautiful. How beautiful is the body of Christ. And as he laid down his life, we offer this sacrifice, that we will live just as he died, willing to pay the price, willing to pay. How beautiful the radiant bride who waits for her groom with his light in her eyes. How beautiful when humble hearts give the fruit of pure lives so that others may live. How
compassionate God, you have fed us with the bread of heaven. Sustain us in our Lenten pilgrimage. May our fasting be hunger for justice, our alms a making of peace, and our prayer the song of grateful hearts. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen.
Make a wish that they were nice, on the outside looking bored. Shine, let it shine before all men, let them see good works in them, let them glorify the Lord. Shine, I wonder what you got, make a wish that they were nice, on the outside looking bored. Shine, make a shine before all men, let them see good works in them. Let him glorify the Lord.
Serve and love the Lord.